Today we're going to be having a look at the Microsoft PC Manager, which some people are saying is like CCleaner, but designed by Microsoft. And I'm going to give you my thoughts along the way and see if this program is any good. Now to start off, you can get it straight from the Microsoft store as well, but I'm just going to download it from the Microsoft webpage here. But before we do that, let's just have a look at what Microsoft says this thing does. So it boosts your PC, cleans up system files and free up space, boosts your performance. It also manages your storage. It can block pop-up in Windows apps, which, well, shouldn't be there in the first place. It, like, there shouldn't be ads in Windows anyway, but okay, we're going to have a look at that. Then it can give you a health checkup, can scan for threats. It's got a toolbox and mini toolbar, which gives you this type of widget, it seems, on your desktop. So let's go ahead and download it and see how it works. So I'm just going to click on the download button here, which will download the installer. If we open that, it's going to start downloading and installing this Microsoft PC Manager. Now it says it's using the Microsoft Store, but I don't even actually have the Microsoft Store installed on this computer. So it's probably just using one of those dependencies. So it's finished downloading and installing now. I'm not going to let this start automatically when I sign into Windows, but we can start the app. And the first problem we have here is it's missing a required runtime, and I can try and download the runtime. So I also don't have Microsoft Edge installed on this computer, which is probably the issue because it's downloading Microsoft Edge WebView. So I'll go ahead and run that, which will download and install Microsoft Edge WebView to runtime. And this is also a dependency for some Adobe apps. So this is one of those things, if you do remove Microsoft Edge from your computer, you might have this type of issue. Now, hopefully this doesn't install Microsoft Edge back onto the computer. Not that I think Microsoft Edge is a bad browser, but the ads on the homepage is what bothers me, and then as well as it forcing you to use Bing, or constantly nagging you to use Bing as your search engine. If I can fix those two issues, then I might probably use Microsoft Edge as my main browser. So it's finished installing. I'm just going to click on retry, and it looks like it's repairing. So it looks like it's done repairing and it just launched for the first time. So what do we have here? We can boost the PC performance, we can manage our storage, and we can safeguard digital assets. So right here, reset Edge browser's default search engine to Bing. If I was using Edge, I wouldn't want that. So that, I don't like that at all. Just gonna uncheck that in any case and click on OK, which will launch the PC manager here. So let's have a look at the homepage. So first off, we can boost the PC performance. If I click on that, what does it do? It basically deletes temporary files, and I think it clears out some RAM. Then we also have this smart boost button up here, which takes us to the settings. So we can enable this to let PC Manager automatically boost our PC when there's high usage of RAM or there are 1 gigabyte of temporary files. So I guess that's pretty cool. We can switch that on. Then for the general settings, I mean, if you are going to use the PC Manager, then you probably want to have it enabled when you sign into Windows. So if you are planning on using this, if you do like it, then make sure that it automatically starts up when you sign into Windows. But if we go back to the homepage, we can do a health check, which will scan for a few things. So let's see what it found. Select actions to proceed. So reset Edge defaults. If we hover here, it wants to restore the search engine to Bing. Again, Microsoft, why? Why do you want to do that? Reset the taskbar to its default appearance and disable third-party extensions. I also don't want to do that. I'm using Start Allback on my computer, which is a shell replacement. So I'm not using the default taskbar in any case. So for this PC health checkup, I don't agree with these two options, that it wants to reset the search engine of Edge to Bing and reset my taskbar settings that I have. I don't agree with that, but this does seem quite nice, where it wants to clean up the Windows cache, temp files, which we've already done with the boost, and then system logs. Then you also have some startup apps here. Now on your computer, you probably have a whole list of startup items. I don't have that many on this computer, so I only have the Windows security notification that's enabled, because all of the other startup apps I've already disabled in the task manager, which you can just do by going to task manager, startup apps, and then all of these other things have been disabled as well. So you don't need PC Manager to do that, but I'm going to go ahead and click on proceed so it can run these tasks, and then we're going to go ahead and click on done. If we go to the process tab here, we can see a list of the processes. So this is basically also the same thing that you can see inside of Task Manager, but it's a little bit more cleaned up. You don't have all of the services and stuff showing here. You just have these processes, and then you can end them, like Microsoft Edge updates. I can end that. So this is a nice list that you can just use to quickly end the tasks with. If you go back to home and we do a deep cleanup, it's going to scan for files that we can clean up. So we can clean up Windows Update, we can clean up Windows Defender files and temp files, which we've done before already. Then we can also clean up Windows Prefetch, remote desktop cache and delivery optimization files. I think this is quite nice. We have application cache that we can clear. I'll go ahead and select that. There's some files in the recycle bin, and then there's the web cache. So I'm going to go ahead and select all of these and then click on proceed, which will basically clean up almost 1.5 gig of drive space on my computer. So that's quite nice. I like that. Then startup is basically the same startup process as we saw earlier. And it also recommends keeping on Realtek, which is the driver. So that's good. I think that's pretty useful seeing that. Now, if you go over to protection, we've got this virus and threat protection here, which will basically just take us to Windows security. We've got Windows update, default browser settings, which I'm guessing wants us to use Microsoft Edge, which isn't installed anyway. Then we can repair the taskbar, which I don't want to do. And then we can also reset default apps to open files, which I guess might be useful in some cases if your app defaults aren't working properly. But then again, this is going to reset everything back to Edge. Your PDFs are going to open with Microsoft Edge, and it's basically just going to force using all of the Microsoft products, and it's most probably also going to reset the search engine to Bing. Then we have this pop-up management, which blocks pop-up windows in apps. So we can enable this to block those pop-ups, and it invites us to join the Microsoft PC Manager pop-up management program. After joining this, you can take screenshots of pop-ups that you don't want to see but can't close and send us the screenshots to optimize the pop-up management feature. You can choose not to participate and a whole bunch of other stuff, and then we do not collect information or any other screenshots that you send us. No thanks, I'm not going to be doing that, but I will enable the pop-up block. I'm just not exactly sure what it's blocking. Is it ads in Windows or what is it? If you know, let me know in the comments down below, but I don't want to see ads in Windows, so I'll leave this selected and see how it works. Then if you go to storage, we've already done a scan of the drives before. Then you can manage your downloaded files, you can manage large files, and you can scan for duplicate files, which might be very useful as well. And then you have Storage Sense, which is basically part of Windows, which you can configure without this app. But I must mention that I think this duplicate files finder is quite handy. I'm not going to be scanning for duplicate files in this video, but I think this could be very useful. And also the large files finder. Usually I use a program called WizTree to find large files, but this could also work pretty well. So I do think this is quite useful. And then for the apps, we can check out the app management section here, where we can again manage our processes, which is what we've done before. We can have a look at the startup apps. We can uninstall apps, which I'm guessing will basically just show us the same thing we get in Windows, but where we can uninstall anything really easily. And it looks like Microsoft Edge was reinstalled when I downloaded this app. So if we go back to the apps section here, we also have Microsoft Store. Now, I don't have the Microsoft Store installed on this computer. If I click on this, is it going to open it? No, it doesn't have a link to open the Microsoft Windows Store, because I don't have it installed. So I'm just going to go ahead and click on OK. But this would just open the Microsoft Store on your computer so you can get to that and browse for more apps. If we go to the toolbox section here, what do we have? We have the show toolbar on the desktop. And this is the widget that we saw on the web page earlier. So if we click on this, it's going to boost the computer. Then we have Notepad, which opens Notepad on our computer. And then we also have Edge Quick Links, which makes us open Edge. So Edge is reinstalled, and I'm guessing the Microsoft PC Manager didn't just reinstall the WebView runtime too, it also installed Edge as a whole. Now here's the problem I have with Edge. There's an ad. If you scroll down, there's an ad, there's another ad, and it basically just shows you a whole bunch of news that you don't want to see. Now, I am aware that if you click on the settings here, you can toggle off the feed so you don't see that. So that is a way of getting rid of it. But normally after a few days, Microsoft prompts you to re-enable that, or it just gets re-enabled by itself after an update. And that's what I don't like. If we click on the settings here, we can open the PC manager from this widget. We can add some more tools like PC boost, search, captions, currency converter, translator, the weather, and all of that. That's honestly not something that I use, but I'm just showing it to you in this video in case you want to try out this app for yourself, and then you can also search the web here. So after checking out this app, I do think it has a place. It can definitely help you in some regards, like it's really easy cleaning up space with this deep clean function here and cleaning your temporary files and stuff. So this could help you maintain your computer and manage your computer, as it's called. And a lot of these functions you already have access to in Windows itself, in the Windows settings like task manager and disk management and that type of thing. But this PC manager app just makes it a little bit easier to get to those settings and to help you keep your PC optimized. So if you want to use PC manager, go ahead and check it out for yourself. I'll also leave the download links in my written guide that you can find on my website, and a link to that will be down in the description of this video. But with that being said, if you found this video useful, give it a like. And if you want to support this channel, you can check out my YouTube members section. Shout out to the existing members. I really appreciate your support, and I'll talk to all of you guys soon.